Speaker TV.
Hello, we are White Rabbits, and you're watching Speaker TV.
It's snowing in New York when we left. It's probably the most abrupt climate change I've ever experienced in my life. We've had some good shows in the UK. We've been to Germany a few times, Amsterdam a few times, France a couple times. No jail. No. No jail yet.
We keep trying, but it never. We can't get into jail as hard as we try. We did Glastonbury, that was a standout. We've only played it once, but it was extremely memorable, you know, up to your knees in mud and just extreme inconvenience and so uncomfortable, but it was still a good time somehow after all that. After we moved to New York, we played the Mercury Lounge. Seems to be a common thing with all New York bands, like once you get to play the Bowery Ballroom, it's kind of a big step.
We kind of leveled off.
We peaked at the Bowery Ballroom. I would say more often than not, we start off with like a sort of either a drum beat or a rhythmic sort of idea as a foundation, and then just kind of, once we're all excited about that, then we'll build a song around that, just, you know, build up from there. But there's a couple tracks in this record that, on It's Frightening, that just started off in a very traditional, just kind of like acoustic guitar demo, and fleshed out as a band. So since we all write, thankfully it's not a streamlined process, it changes every song, which is a good thing for us, because we get bored easily, so it's good to keep it interesting. Well, everyone we like drums a lot, obviously. More recently, we've been influenced by a lot more like drum and bass kind of stuff. All big fans of Aphex Twin. I don't know, for me, as a pianist, I'm really influenced by Steve Naive of The Attractions, Elvis Costello's band. You know, we all listen to a lot of reggae and, yeah, Nick Cave. Wolf Mother and Silverchair, that's it.